Hello everyone. So today we are going to see examples on procedure with parameters. In the previous video we have seen the example on procedure without parameter. So these are the example without parameter. In that we created the procedure and we print this message. And in next example we have write a procedure to display sum of two numbers. Here is the procedure we have seen. And so there are two ways we can execute the procedure. First one is execute procedure name and second one is by using anonymous block. And also we have seen the advantages and procedure syntax and why we need a store procedure and what is store procedure. So now let us see the some examples on procedure with parameters. So we will see now procedures with parameter. So this is the first example. So let me copy this and go to SQL plus prompt and paste here. So let us understand what is this. So create or replace, for creating a procedure, create or replace procedure, and this is a procedure name add underscore procedure, and these are the parameter a number, a is a variable name and number is data type, b is a variable name, number is data type, and is. Now here execution block started. Now here we will print. So dbms underscore output dot put underscore line for printing. This will print sum of two number as a plus b. This is concat operator, concatenation and end of the procedure. Now let us execute this. And so how can we execute this? So for that we need to pass these two. So we will pass two values for this procedure. So how to execute? Execute then procedure name, what is add underscore proc, then pass the values 10 20 10 comma 20. So what will happen? This 10 go here and it will be stored in A, and this 20 will be go here and this will be stored in B. Then what happened? Sum of two number will be printed and a plus b, what is it? 30 will be printed. So sum of two number equal to 30 will be printed. Now let us execute this and here we go. Sum of two numbers equals to 30. Then another way of executing procedure is what? By using anonymous block. So here we will say begin, and here we need to give this call the procedure and end slash, and here we go sum of two number as 30. Then here we are hard coding the values. So if we want to take the values, how can you do? Execute add underscore procedure ampersand, we need to use ampersand b because there are two parameters. So it will ask the value of a, let us take 45. And what is value of b? If we take 65, and here we go, we are getting the result as 1110. So this is the example we have seen. Now let's see next example. So now we will see procedures return values through the parameter mode. So there are three types of parameters mode. First one is in mode, next one out mode, and third one is in out mode. So what is in mode? It accepts the input into the sub program and it is a default mode. That means in the previous year procedure, what internally A in, so the default mode of A and B are in. So if we didn't write, that means it internally uses in mode. So we called it as default. So this, you can see this is the example create or replace this procedure. This and whatever you have seen, these are same. Just this is we are writing in, but internally it is by default here in is there. Next one is out. It returns the output through a sub program. We will see one of the examples, and same is as in out both. In out means both in mode and out mode. We will see examples. So if we take here in C, C++, Java, we take int a and we take the value from the user A, B, C. Let us see, these are the two, three variables, and we are taking the value of A and B from the user, and C equals to A plus B we are doing, and we are doing return C. So in that case, we are taking two values from the user. That means these are in mode in the PL SQL, and we are returning the value. That means this is in out mode. We have to take this variable in out mode and this A and B in mode. Then what is about in out? So let us see, we are taking int A, and A value we are taking from user, and what we are doing, A equal to A cross A, and we need to return A. That means we are taking the value A from the user, and also we are returning the value of A. So this is doing both in and out. So we will see one of the example and understand. So first we will see the example of in. So in is simple, as we have seen. So let us copy this and go to SQL Plus, clear the screen, and here we go. So create or replace procedure, and this is the procedure name A. This is the mode. A in means we need to give the value of A, and also for B. Then is begin, then this is the execution block, and here we are writing the logic to print the A plus B. Now let us execute this procedure. Now we need to execute this. So for execute add underscore procedure PROC, now we need to pass the value 10 comma 30, and here we go, sum of two numbers are 40. So this is the in mode. Now next we will see about out. So let's copy this example. Now go here, and here we go. So let me take here some space. So now here what we are doing, let us understand. So create or replace procedure, add underscore procedure, and A is in mode, B is in mode, and but the C variable is out mode. That means it returns the value of C. So here is, then execution block started, and here C equal, we are assigning value of A plus B to C, and end of the this procedure. Now let us execute this slash. So procedure is created. So how to execute this? So if I give here execute add underscore procedure, and if I give here 20, and if I execute this, here we are getting the error, because what is the error? Wrong number of types of argument. So here there are three parameters, but we are passing only two, that is 10 on 20. So make sure that in the procedure, whatever the number of parameters available, so we need to pass that much argument while calling the procedure. So here for this out mode, we need to use the bind variable. So let us see what is a bind variable. So here I have written, to execute the above procedure, we need to follow this. First one, here we need to declare the bind variable. And what is the, how can we declare that bind variable? Where, and this is a bind variable name, we can take anything, and this is a data type of bind variable. So to declare a variable on SQL prompt, those variables are called as global variable, bind variables, or SQL buffer, and also we can say that a reference variable. And bind variables are represented with this colon operator. So let us go to SQL plus prompt, and for this out, we need to create a one bind variable. So how to create? So where we, here we need to take where, and any bind variable name we can take. Let us take if we take the bind variable name d, then we need to provide here its data type. Let's take number. And yes, this now the bind variable is created. Now it's time to see how can we use this. So make sure that while using the bind variable are represented with this colon operator. So let us go to SQL plus prompt, and how can we call this procedure? Let us see. So execute add underscore procedure, then 10, 20, and now we need to use here this bind variable for this variable called c. So how to use this? Here we need to take colon b, whatever the variable name d. This is called bind. This operator we need to use with the bind variable. Now if I execute this, and here we go, we are not getting any error. PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Now what is happening? Let me enter internally what is happened here. Let me zoom. Now internally what has happened, this 10 value will be gone to this a. So in the a variable 10 will be stored, then in the b variable 20 will be stored, and in this c this d will be stored. So what happened here, as we go into execution block, here the result will be d equals to d colon equals to what is the value of a 10, then what is the value of b 20, and d equals to 30. So the 30 will be stored in the d. Now how to print this bind variable? Let us see. Our PL SQL procedure successfully completed, and whatever this result of c, that is we are taking is mode as out, that will be stored in the d. Then how can we print that? So for that we need to use print and the bind variable name as d, and if we go here, and here we can see 30 is coming. So again if I execute and at the place of here, if we take 40 and if we take here a 50 and we are passing this bind variable, then if I execute this, here we can see PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Now what will happen? At the place of A 40, at the place of B 50, and at the place of C bind variable will come, and whatever A plus B that will be stored in bind variable. Now let us see by printing this bind variable how to print. Print and bind variable name D, and here we go, 40 plus 50 is 90. So for this out mode we need to use bind variable. How to declare variable? Where variable name and number, and while passing we need to use this colon operator. So this is we have seen. Now we can use any number of bind variables. So let us see one of example. So if I create here create or replace procedure, yes, p5 store procedure 5, and if I take here a and its mode is in, and its data type is number, and here we'll take b and its mode is out and its data type is number, and also in this we will take c and its mode is out and number. So create or replace procedure sp5 a in number, b out number, c out number, as then execution block started, begin. Here what we'll do, b equals to colon equals to, we'll take a square of a, and for c we will take cube of a. So a into a into a, then end of the execution block. Now let us execute this, and here we go, procedure is created. Now there are two variables with out mode, that means we need to create two bind variables. So let us create two bind variable. So first one I will create here variable square, for I am taking the first variable name sq for storing the square. So, and its data type as number. So first bind variable created sq. Next bind variable for c we will create as cube. So where cube and its data type is number. So two bind variables are created. Now it's time to call this procedure. So execute this procedure specify. We need to pass if I want to find the square and cube of 10, then 10, then for b we need to pass the bind variable, so for that colon sq, then for c we will pass colon cube, this bind variable called cube. Now what will happen in this a, this 10 will be stored, and in this b this sq, and for c this cube. So what will happen here, let us understand. Sq is equal to 10 into 10, that is 100. Then cube is equals to a cross a cross a, that means 1000. So sq and cube value will this 100 and 1000. Now let us execute this, and here we go, PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Now how can we print this value? So for printing, print sq space cube semicolon and execute this. Here we go, sq value is 100 and cube value is 1000. If I execute, if you want the, if we pass 8 and if we want the square of 8 and cube of 8, then execute this procedure and procedure is successfully completed. Now we print sq space cube and here we go, square of 8 is 64 and cube of 8 is 512. So this is a way we can use the out mode. Next we will see last mode, that is in out. So this is generally not used, very less times we will using this. Now let us see about in out. So let me copy this and go to here, clear the screen, and here we go. So here we are using in out mode. Let's understand. So what we are doing, create or replace procedure add underscore procedure a, and its mode is in out and data type is number, is then execution block started, and here we are writing the logic to execute and end of the procedure, and this is for execution. So here we are taking a, is mode is in and out both, that means we will take the value of a and we'll also store the output in that. So now let us see by execute this, and here we go, procedure is created. Now here what we are doing, we are passing the value in same variable and we want the output in same variable. So how to do it? First step is we need to create a bind variable. So how to create bind variable, where, and here we will take, so where and bind variable name we will take here. What will the bind variable name? We will take here b and its data type as number. Then here we need to pass the value for this bind variable. So how to assign the value? Execute colon b, and how to assign colon equals to, if I want 10, then semicolon, PL SQL procedure successfully completed. That means what we are doing, we are assigning values to this bind variable. Now we will execute this procedure. How to execute? Execute, and here we will pass bind variable called b. Here we need to write a procedure name, add underscore procedure and bind variable b. and let us execute this. Here we go, PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Now let us print this B. So print this bind variable called B, and here we go, 1000 is coming. So for working with inout, what we have to do? First we need to create a bind variable. First step is creating bind variable, and next step is assigning the value to the bind variable. Here we can see this is assigning the value to bind variable as 10, and last step is execute the procedure with bind variable. By passing the bind variable we are passing, then what happen in the A, 10 will be stored. So 10 into 10 into 10 in that bind variable B, our output, that is this result, will be stored. And finally we are printing print B equals to 1000. So this is the way we can work with inout. Here you can see for working this, working with, we need to create a bind variable, and to assign a value into a bind variable A, we need to this execute colon A, and we need to assign this value called 10. Then we need to execute the procedure in this way. And also, how can we find all the procedure names whatever we have created? So for that we need to use this dictionary called user underscore object. So let us see how many procedure we have created and their names. So for that we need required this query called select object underscore name from user underscore object, where object type is equal to procedure. So if you want functions, then you can give your functions. If you want triggers in the object type name, you can give triggers. Now we are dealing with procedure, so let us see with procedure. So let me copy this and go to SQL Plus. But here in my SQL Plus it is not executing, this is executing, and here you can see that the whatever procedure names, you can see this is we have created, and I have already created other procedure, that name you can see, and we have created stored procedure 5, stored procedure 4, stored procedure 3. So if here we can see there is no stored procedure 6, if we create, and let us see whether that procedure will come in here or not. So let me go here, and if I create one of the procedure, here you can see we have in the previous example we have created this procedure add underscore procedure, and in this list you can see add underscore procedure. Also if we create one of the procedure, let us see what are our procedure name, this add underscore procedure. Let us go here, let us create one procedure. Let me create here, we will create or replace procedure. We will take the procedure name as 6, already there is available store procedure 6. We will take 7. Here you can see there is no procedure with 7. So how can we create or replace procedure SP6? Then here what we'll do, we will take A in and its data type as number. Also we will take here B in number and as, then begin, and here we print dbms underscore output dot put underscore line and product of A and B, concat this, and here we will product A cross B. So end of the procedure, and let's execute. Here you can see procedure is created. So we have taken the same name. It is already available. Now let us see, take say one as that. In the place of store procedure, we will take say one. And if I execute this, as begin, print this, end of the procedure, slash, and procedure is created. Now this name is sp7. Now let us execute this and let us see, this should come our procedure name. So what we have to do, execute this query. Select object underscore name from which table? From user underscore object, where object type is procedure. If I execute this, and here we go, sp7 is coming. Here you can see, if I zoom here, here you can see sp7. SP7 is coming. This is SP7, you can see. So here we are creating the procedure, and here you can see SP7. So whatever the procedure, if you want to see, you can this execute this query. Select object name, object underscore name from user object, where object type is equal to procedure. And also there is next. Yes, so for procedure bodies are stored in user underscore source. So if you want to see any procedure body, you can execute this query. So let me copy this and go to SQL Plus, and here we go. So here we will provide our procedure name. Let us see what we have created, sp7. So if I give up here sp7, so here we have created SP7 procedure. If we want the body of this procedure, how can we find? So if I execute this, and here we go, we are getting the body of this. So whatever we have written procedure SP7, we are taking two values, A in number, B in number, as begin DBMS underscore we are printing. So if you want the body of any procedure, this query, you can execute. Let me zoom this. Yes. This is select text from user underscore source, where name, we have to pass the name of this procedure. So if I give here a sp5, let us take, and here we go, we have seen the example, right? We are taking the B and C as in out mode, and A is in mode, and B equals to square of A and C equals to cube of A. So if you want the body of procedure, you can write this query. Select text from user underscore source, where name is equal to the procedure name you need to pass. And the last one is, we can also drop the procedure. How to drop that procedure? So let me clear the screen. And first of all, what we'll do, we'll see what are the procedure present. For that, we need to execute this query. So go here and paste here. If yes, yeah, now here you can see these are the procedure. And what we are doing, if I want to drop this procedure code sp7, so let us see how can we drop. So for that, what is the syntax? Drop procedure and procedure name. So copy this and go here, paste here, drop, what is which procedure we want to drop, sp7 we need to drop. And if I drop here, procedure is drop. Now let us see in the procedures, if I execute this, copy this and paste here, and here we go, sp7, we can't here we can see sp7 is not in this table, because what we are doing, we are dropping that procedure sp7. In the earlier, before dropping this procedure, you can see there is sp7 procedure, but after here we can see there is no sp7, because we are drop this. So this is the way we can drop the procedure. So for dropping, this is the syntax. Next, if you want to see the body of any procedure, then we need to execute this query. Select text from user underscore source where name of, and here we need to pass the procedure name. Next, what are the procedure present? Whatever we have created, you can see by this query. Select object underscore name from user underscore object, where object underscore type equal to procedure. Next, we have seen the example on in-out mode, how to use for and how to execute with the bind variables and how to assign the value to the bind variable. Next, we have seen with the out mode, then how to execute, deal with the out. For that we need to use the bind variable. Next, in mode we have seen, and there are three parameter modes. First one is in, second one is out, and third one is in out. So this is a way, and these are the examples on procedure with parameters.